Zana and I, we speak as one. And because of that, it's so much more than the sum of the parts. I verbally speak, and I am acting as the voice for us. And Zana feels, holds, opens, and communicates all that is invisible, that holds the energy of the intention, the pure intention behind the words, and the all the possibilities that extend out from our shared vision. So this is how we work together as one. Okay. So before we begin, I just want to we want to share something with you that's very, actually very wonderful and points to everything that we wish to express.
Fresh.
And it's so fresh, it just happened maybe an hour ago. So I'm holding up a sketch.
Wow.
Okay. So this is a sketch we did last night for a place that we wish to build in the heartland of Slovakia. And effectively, it's a small home for that part of the world for us. And this was between us, it emerged quite spontaneously. And, you know, we didn't show it to anyone. It's not on internet. We don't do that. And then just as we were listening earlier to the wonderful presenters, Zana asked her six-year-old daughter, Angelica, if she would feel like just drawing something that would represent a school for her, because she actually only started primary school, as I would call it, primary school just 2 weeks ago. Wow. So everything is very new for her, the system, the control grid, everything. So so here's what she drew.
Wow.
So you can see the resonance.
Amazing.
So this is, now remember, she saw nothing. She wasn't trying to copy a sketch that she saw. This was
pure
from the field. And I know you know what that means. This field of consciousness, this morphogenic informational field that is continuously changing like a cymatic function, a collective consciousness projection. And that those that have ears to hear and eyes to see and other senses that aren't normally given much credibility, those senses can connect us with shared visions and possible futures and new timelines. And that's very much what we're interested in, very much what fuels our passion and drives our desire to open the world. And actually between us, we have seven children. And those children have and continue to be through the full spectrum of educational possibilities. My own children were home educated. They had informal, natural learning, no curriculum. And so they've all continue and to move through into life with their own passions intact and their own sense of who they are. And Zana's children are very much keeping hold of that potential in themselves. And actually, in my view, having a tougher job because they are in the system. So, and meanwhile, in the background of that, we're both hugely interested in education for ourselves, for others, for our families, of course, but what it means for us to continue to learn, continue to remember, continue to connect, and to use that connectivity to create consciously. And so education for us, it's just a word, we know that in whatever language, but education for us is a force that gives us that gives anybody the possibility to create consciously. That's the key.
Yes.
And one of the shared quotations that has independently stimulated us in the past has been that by Einstein, and I'm paraphrasing because I don't know the exact words, but effectively it was, you cannot solve a problem with the same mind that created it. No. Our children have inherited our problem, that we created this system, we created this spectrum of assumptions and projections that we put onto our young minds, and in order for them to become like Prakash said, like good citizens in the world, you know? And then you see what happens when that beautiful kindergarten in Japan was created, breaking some rules, and then the whole system changed as a result of that commitment. So we have a presentation we'd like to share with you because we know time is short. May we do so?
Yes.
All right, so here we go. Can you guys see this okay? Is it coming up for you?
Okay.